Hey guys, welcome to the world of English exams. This video is going to be about common nouns and proper nouns. Both these types of nouns are very important for the IELTS test preparation, mainly because the listening and the reading tests are objective based and most of the answers would be nouns. So you need to understand what a common noun is and what a proper noun is so that you can mark them as keywords and you can get the answer, predict the answer better and not miss the score in the reading and listening tests. Of course, even for the writing and speaking test, you need to base your answer on nouns. So without any delay, let's start today's topic by understanding what are nouns and what are the different types of nouns. And then we will progress with understanding about common nouns and proper nouns. Pay attention because 90% of the answers in the listening and reading tests of the IELTS test are based on nouns, mainly common and proper nouns. So stay tuned. So nouns are naming words. These are the words that are used to give a name to a person, a place, an animal, a thing, an idea, an emotion, a feeling, an expression, whatnot. So if you are naming something, automatically you should use a noun. So now under the category of nouns are common nouns, proper nouns, collective nouns, abstract nouns, singular and plural nouns, material nouns, countable and uncountable nouns, concrete nouns and abstract nouns. So previously, if you follow our YouTube channel, you might have known that we have previously released the videos for compound nouns as well as for concrete and abstract nouns. So this video is going to combine common and proper. So in the forthcoming videos, you will understand about collective nouns and countable, uncountable and material nouns as well. So stay tuned to our YouTube channel World of English Exams. And let me tell you guys that this video is not just helpful for those candidates who are taking the IELTS test, but in general, if anybody wishes to learn English, that is spoken English or written English, whatever form of English it is very important to start with the basics like this. So let us understand what are common nouns and what are some of the examples of these common nouns. So common, the name itself indicates that these nouns do not indicate any particular object or person. Common means general, usual. So not a specific or unique identity. It refers to general names. For instance, if you take the word boy, so if I give a sentence which contains this noun called boy, am I referring to any particular boy or am I referring to a general category? Yes, so I am referring to a general category. I am not specifying any particular person. So that noun, so such nouns which do not indicate any specific category and they only refer to general names are known as common nouns. So now comes the concept that you need to use in your listening and reading tests. If you have to write the answer which is a common noun, you need not write them in capital letters. Often many students leave a query on our website worldofenglishexams.com as to whether to write the answers using capital letters or lowercase letters. Let me tell you one thing specifically, guys. When the answer has to be written in the form of a proper noun, you need to write them in capital letter. Which means if you know that a particular noun is a proper noun, then definitely you need to write that in capital letters only. However, that is not a mandate with common nouns. With common nouns, you can write the answer in the case of lowercase or uppercase. But as it is acceptable in the test to go ahead and write all the answers in all capital letters, I would advise all the candidates to adopt this method. You don't need to worry whether the answer is a common noun or proper noun. Whatever answer it is, write it in the form of all capital letters. Now you may ask me, ma'am, is it acceptable if I write the answer in all caps? Obviously, it is acceptable. You can refer to the official British Council or IDP website for the tips and instructions, and in that you can clearly see that you can write all the answers in all capital letters. In that way, you are avoiding this risk of losing marks because of the grammatical correctness of the word. So, common nouns in general need not be capitalized. However, there is a small condition here. If these nouns are used in a heading, let's say you're starting the sentence with a common noun, then automatically they need to be capitalized because capital letters come under punctuation marks. So you should not avoid that. If any sentence begins with a common noun, obviously you need to start it with a capital letter. However, if these words are seen in the mid of sentences or towards the end of sentences, you essentially need not capitalize them. So this is the basic rule behind common nouns. Now let's look at some examples of common nouns. Boys, I'm not referring to any particular boy here. Restaurant, again, I'm not naming any restaurant. Chocolate, friend, subject, in this case, subject indicate education related subjects. Language, country, singer, artist, teacher, fruit, birds, vegetables, movie, day, song, car, class, institute, course, beach, book. So now what did you understand from all these guys? Have you seen that I did not write the first alphabet in capital letter? Because that is the basic rule of common nouns. There is no need to write them in capital letter. However, if they come in the starting of sentences, then definitely you need to write them in capital letter. For example, chocolates are sweet. So their chocolates, in the word chocolate, C has to be written as a capital letter. Then, boys are trustworthy people. So boys, in the word boys, B has to be written in capital letter. Okay, so then, books are fun to read. So in the word books, even though you know that book is a common noun, you need to start it with capital letter as the sentence is beginning with a capital letter. So this is the one concept which many of the IELTS test takers often forget to realize. So please do realize this fact and use it when you're writing your IELTS test. Okay, so now shall we move on to the next concept, that is proper nouns. Okay, so proper nouns, in contrast to the common nouns where they do not refer to any particular individual or place or thing, proper nouns do refer to specific people. They indicate a particular person, a particular place, a particular thing or an object which can be given a name. For example, the names of people, the names of places, the names of animals, the names of things. I'm not talking them as a category, but I'm naming them actually. So for example, a tiger, then Paris, then so let's say you can talk about any name of scientist that you can see in the IELTS test. So all these names indicate proper nouns because proper indicates particular, specific, unique. So you need to use a proper noun to name a particular thing or a particular place or a person. So because you are giving a specific identity to that particular noun, you need to use a capital letter while referring to this. I have seen a couple of students who lost the score in listening and reading because they prefer to write the answer in the form of lowercase, but they did not use a capital letter while indicating a proper noun. So that can be a mistake, guys. So it all depends on the candidate whether he or she wants to write the answers in uppercase or lowercase. However, for proper nouns, it is always suggestible to write the answer which starts with a capital letter, because it helps in identifying. So proper nouns play a vital role in identifying the name, identifying a person. Hence, you need to use capital letters as a rule. So you don't need to bother whether these proper nouns are used in the starting of a sentence or towards the end or the middle. Wherever proper nouns are used, as a thumb rule, you need to capitalize them. And this proves to be very essential in your writing test, mainly because you are not expected to write the entire test in capital letters. Of course, that is not possible, right? So using the proper nouns appropriately with the correct formation is very, very important in your writing test, whether it is academic test or general training test. This sounds to be true for both the modules. So now let's understand some examples of these proper nouns. Dairy milk, of course, our favorite chocolate. Then physics, name of a subject, so P has to be capital. Tom, Australia, English, Saturday, the Indian Ocean, Japan, Mr. Black. So you can see that all these are proper nouns because they are helping in identification of a particular noun. If you look at the specific example of the Indian Ocean, if you don't indicate the term Indian and specify the name of the ocean, if you just write the term ocean, then it is going to become a common noun. So you need not write it in capital letters. However, because you are giving a particular name and identifying a particular ocean, this has to be in capital letters only. So this is the major concept, major difference between a common noun and a proper noun, guys. So I hope all of you have had a fair idea and understanding of common nouns and proper nouns. So till I see you with the next informative video, let me tell you that we are going to come up with more and more exclusive grammar videos, which will definitely help you in your IELTS preparation. And parallelly, we are also coming up with solved reading test videos from the latest edition of Cambridge, that is Cambridge 14. So if you haven't checked out our latest videos, please do visit our channel World of English Exams, and you can find loads of interesting stuff and information that can ease your preparation. And not just solving, we are also telling you the right strategy so that you can implement that in your main exam. So do check those videos out, and please leave a comment on this video if you found it useful. Do like this and share it with your friends because they might need it. And last but not least, please do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel World of English Exams, and we are coming up with more interesting videos and useful information for your IELTS preparation, as well as for those of you who are passionate about learning English, whether it is spoken English or written English. So thank you so much for watching the video till the end, guys. So I hope all of you have understood the concept because I've given a lot of examples. So thank you very much, and I'll see you with the next video.